Hello. It's time to look at the set collection type. The set can be useful when you need unique items or you want to do logical operations. Also in this lab, we're going to see an example of the non-local declaration. We already learned the global declaration for when we want to do an assignment into a global identifier. Now we're going to see the non-local declaration, the other one. The set container type is about unique items, not in a list because it's not ordered, or it's ordered like a dictionary is ordered, a hash table order for going through it quickly. We'll see. If you make a basket of items, but you have little curly braces there instead of round brackets or square brackets, that is a set. And when I ask to print it, you'll see that there are no duplicates, that the duplicates have been removed. I can ask questions like orange in basket, and it'll tell me true, or crabgrass in basket, and that's a false. And that's fast. You don't want to do a loop yourself. You want your loop to go on in compiled C. Well, let's look at some operations. Another way to initialize a set is to use the built-in type set. And then you can give it any sequence. And then when you look at it again, you'll see that all the duplicate characters have been removed. The sequence here is a string. If I wish to not use the word set, but I want curly braces, then my characters have to go in comma separated, and that happens, if you remember, with the asterisk. The minus sign is defined. If I say spell minus charm, it's going to give me all the characters that are in spell, but not in charm, and that's all there are. If I use the pipe symbol for OR, then I get all the characters that are in spell and charm, but they're never duplicated. The ampersand gives me just the characters that are in both spell and charm. There's only two of those. I should point out that there are some built-in methods for these things. There is the spell dot difference, and then I say charm, and that's just like spell minus charm. Union is the same as the or sign, and the ampersand can instead be the intersection of spell and charm, whichever one you prefer. There is also the symmetric difference. Now that is a little caret. Or spell dot symmetric difference charm. That means all the characters that are in spell or charm, but not both. Perhaps most useful to you will be set.add. Here we're seeing the help output for set.add, and it adds an element to your set, or not if it's already in there. Let's look at a little demo. Demo set. We'll start by looking at main, where we see we call find unique words, and if we get any, then we're going to print them. Well, let's go look at find unique words. We start on line 11 by making the empty set. Now look at this. We're going to do a lister through the current directory. And if our file that comes out of that, the file name, does not end with .txt, we'll skip that one. Otherwise, we know we have a file name that ends with a .txt, so we'll open that up. We'll look at each line, and we will then get each word. We will strip off any punctuation. If there's nothing left, we'll skip that. Otherwise, we'll add it, the lowercase version of it, to our unique words, and so it'll only go into our unique words if it hasn't been seen before. So that's a nice sequence of events. I have to really appreciate Python when I see a thing like that. It is so readable. so few lines of code for so much happening. Now we're passing those words into format words. This is a bit fancy because we can specify the width of our output. Here I have the default is 50, good enough. We notice that we have a nested function definition. And there is that non-local declaration. Below that then, here is our format words, where we will make a list of return lines. And we're going to look at lines one at a time, I suppose, because this lines words, these will be output lines. And line length. We're going to sort up our words. So, sorted returns a list of words. And I had to make a list of these words because they were a set. And you cannot sort a set. But we can sort that list, and there it is. Now I'm looking at all the words, one at a time, except the last one. And I suppose I want to stick on an and. Okay, so what I'm really going to print is that word plus a comma space. And I'm going to process word. So what is going to get printed comes in here on line 25. Now we're at the non-local line len. Like global, non-local says, I want to assign into line len, which is defined someplace outside my function, but instead of being out in the global, it's someplace else between here and global, and there it is. There's our line len. So in here, I'm going to be changing my line len. Word len is the length of the word, what's going to get printed, and we add that to our line len. So that's the length of our line. Maybe. If it's too long, then I have some things to do. I am going to then set it to be equal to just this word's length. And my return lines, I do a dot append. Now, that actually is not an assignment, but I am referring to return lines and asking it to append. And return lines is down here. So this list is going to be added to with the line that is the nothing join of the words, just what we want. So that'll be the next line. Now we're going to clear this line's words. So empty them out. This line's words is down here in format words, but once again, because there's the dot, I'm referencing it to start it over. If the line len had not exceeded by width, then I just append it. So it's only when I'm going to exceed my width that I start things over like that. When I'm done going through all my words, processing them, except for the last one, I'm going to then add and that word. So that's going to go in as the last word, period. And on 43, I have to do append of this line's words because I had appended this word on it. It had not been appended here. Never gets appended there. So we did have to do that append. Then we do the new line join of all the return lines. And that gives us our formatted words. You see, for my example run, I moved over to my portable Python lab so that I have some text. That's where all those cats are. And there we have the words. Okay, you are on for an exercise. Good luck.